Here's another animal song. A year ago, last Thursday, I was strolling in the zoo when I met a man who thought he knew the lot. He was laying down the law about the habits of baboons and the number of quills a porcupine has got. So I asked him, "What's that creature there?" He answered, "Yeah, it's a helk." I might have gone on thinking that was true if the animal in question hadn't put that chap to shame and remarked, "I ain't a helk, I'm a gnu. I'm a gnu. I'm a gnu. The nicest work of nature in the zoo. I'm a gnu. How do you do? You really ought to canoe wahoos wahoo. I'm a gnu, spelt G-N-U. I'm not a camel or a kangaroo. So let me introduce, I'm neither man or moose. So gnu, 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 I'm a gnu." I had taken furnished lodgings down at Rustington-on-Sea, whence I travelled on to Ashton-under-Lyme, it was actually. And the second night I stayed there, I was wakened from a dream, which I'll tell you all about some other time. Among the hunting trophies on the wall above my bed, stuffed and mounted, was a face I thought I knew. A bison? No, it's not a bison. An okapi? It's unlikely, really. Could it be a hearty beast? I seemed to hear a voice. "I'm a gnu. I'm a gnu. A another gnu. I wish I could gnash my teeth at you. I'm a gnu. How do you do? You really ought to know wahoos wahoo. I'm a gnu, spelt G-N-U. Call me bison or a copy and I'll sue. Nor am I in the least like that dreadful, hearty beast. Oh, gnu, gnu, gnu. Gnu, 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 I'm a gnu. Gnu, 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 I'm a gnu."
Nice of you. Architecture, said Hegel, is frozen music, as you'll remember. Donald Swann's music has often been compared with defrosted architecture. Nowhere is this more evident than in his setting which has been described by music critics all over this country as spiffing, of this song,